If you're looking for a to-do list app that integrates seamlessly with Gmail and your Google Workspace, look no further than Google Tasks. So in this video, I'm gonna show you how to use Google Tasks. That's right, this is your complete Google Tasks tutorial. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custodian. Welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and a borderline unhealthy amount of Google tips. And today I want you to think of this as your Google Tasks quick start guide. So first things first, Google Tasks is completely free and it integrates seamlessly with any of your Google accounts. Second, you can use the Google Tasks mobile app for iOS or Android, or use Google Tasks on the web. And third, Tasks is, I would say, a simplistic task manager. So you're not gonna have all of the bells and whistles of some of other task management apps. But with that said, I think there are a ton of strengths found within Google Tasks. So I actually wanna start with what Google Tasks look like on the web, and then later on I'll move into what it looks like for your mobile app. So there's no dedicated web app for Google Tasks that you need to download or anything like that. It's actually found in your suite of Google apps. So you may be familiar with your side panel on the right-hand side of your Gmail or Drive or Calendar. Well, Tasks is found in that right-hand panel. So you can access Google Tasks right from Gmail or when you're working in a Google Doc or when you're adding things to your Google Calendar. So let's start with a Gmail tab here. And all we have to do is head to the right-hand panel and click on the task icon. It's the little blue check mark in the circle. Now this will expand the panel on the right, and you're gonna have a couple of options here. You can simply click on add a task to get started, or just above that, you'll notice you have a drop-down menu where it says my task. This is a default list, and of course you can add a task to that, or you can click on that and then create a new list from here. So since we're in Gmail, let's say we want to create email specific tasks. We can make a new list called email tasks and then just select done. Now we can go ahead and click on add a task, and from here we'll add a title. And then we can add some details of the task, like maybe you have to follow up with someone. And then you can also set a date and time that you want to get a notification for that task. And you also have the option of repeating a task by clicking on the arrows to the right of the date and time. It's really that easy. Now, once you've created tasks, there are a few things you can do to organize the tasks further. So I've populated a few more tasks here in Google Tasks, so you can get a feel for what the panel's gonna look like when it's filled out with more. And let's actually hop over to my Google Calendar tab so that you can see I still have access on the right-hand side to the same task list and tasks right from here too. Because remember, Google Tasks is linked to your Google account, so you can access it on the web from any of your Google account tabs. So with these tasks created, you can simply click and drag to reorder any of them. And the mouse is going to change to a hand. And then when I click and hold on a task, I'm just dragging it and dropping it to the order I want. Or you can click on the three-dot menu icon to the right of the add a task option and click to sort the tasks by date if you prefer. You can also rename the entire list from here too, or delete the entire list as well. Now, within an actual task, if you hover over a task, a three-dot menu icon appears for that specific task. Depending on the task, you're gonna be able to maybe add a subtask, or you might be able to indent it, or you can add that task to a new list if you wanna create a list after the task has already been created. Or you can delete the task from here too. And of course, you can just check off any completed tasks by clicking in the circle icon to the left of the task. Now, once you mark a task complete, you're going to have a completed list. So just at the bottom here, we can click on this to expand our completed list. So here you can delete the completed task, or if you want to undo a task you marked complete by mistake, you just have to unclick the check mark to the left of the task, and then it's going to be moved back up to the list that it came from. But wait, there's more. So let me jump ahead on my calendar view here, and I need to point out that as we added our tasks to Google Tasks, they were automatically added to my GCal at the top. So this test task I made was added to the date that I set it in the task. This is really handy because you don't even have to have this right-hand side panel open in order to get a snapshot of your upcoming tasks. And if you set a specific time for the task, it's going to be added to your GCal at that time. Now, if for some reason you don't have your tasks auto-populating in your GCal, just make sure you have your task calendar toggled on, which is here on the left-hand side of your GCal. With your tasks appearing on your calendar, you can open the task right from there on your calendar, just like you would any other calendar event. So you can edit the task from here, or you can mark it complete from here too. So again, you don't even have to access that right-hand side panel if you don't want to. Now let's jump back to our Gmail view for a moment, because I want to go over another cool feature of Google Tasks. From Gmail, you can actually just drag and drop an email into your tasks panel on the right. Now, this does not affect the email in any way. You won't lose the email from your inbox or anything like that. It's actually going to automatically add the email as a task in Google Tasks. So it's going to auto-title the task the same as the subject line of the email. And you can edit the task just as you would any other task. But cooler yet is, you'll notice it adds a direct link to the corresponding email in the task. So if you click on the little email button within that task, it automatically opens up that email for you. So now you can easily reference any important information that was in that email. How cool is that? So now that we understand how to use Google Tasks on the web, let's take a look at the mobile app. Now remember, this is an app you're going to download to your device either from the App Store or Google Play Store. So when you download the Google Tasks app, you will simply choose the Google account you want to proceed with. As soon as you select your account, any tasks and lists you've already created will automatically be populated on the mobile app for you. Now, if you have multiple Google accounts like I do, no worries, you can easily toggle between your accounts within the app. So to do so, you'll just tap on your profile icon and then select the account you want to switch to. But the mobile app functions very much the same as tasks on the web. You can add a new task by selecting the plus symbol at the bottom, or this may be a blue button that says add a new task if you're on Android, but simply tap on that and you can add a new task. You can just add a little title and hit save, or you can add more details just like you can on the web. And of course, you can hit the calendar icon to add a date and time if you prefer to. So once you hit save, the task is automatically added to your task list. Now, in the bottom left, there is a hamburger menu icon, and if you tap on that, you can access your lists and toggle between them or create a new list right from there. Or tap the three-dot menu icon in the bottom right to sort the order of your tasks, or rename the list, or just delete the list entirely, or delete all completed tasks. So the same functionalities you have on the web, you have on the mobile app. So this concludes your Google Tasks tutorial for beginners. And I'm curious to know if you like the simplicity of Google Tasks and if you use it or will use it to help you, well, stay on task. So that's how to use Google Tasks. What do you think of Google Tasks? How do you think it compares to other to-do list apps and task managers? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know, so give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for even more Google tips. Thanks for watching. See you next time.